Hi guys, I hope you're all well. Firstly, I'd like to make a public apology. In the last video, I felt I gave an unfair beating to Leica M cameras. So in this video, I'm going to cover Leica M film cameras versus Leica 3 Barnet cameras and try to do a quick summary of which is the best camera for you if you're on the market to buy a Leica film camera and you're kind of overwhelmed by the number of different models available. I have done summaries on the different cameras in the past on the MrLeica.com blog, but in this video I'll try and do a quick summary of all the different options. So in this video we'll be looking at Silver Leica M cameras and Silver Leica 3 cameras. And for those of you that like your black paint, we'll also be looking at Black Leica M cameras and Black Leica Barnet cameras. Let's take a look. So just to recap, in my last video I talked about ways to hopefully give you a better chance of getting sharp images, and in that video I was saying that Zorki cameras are better than Leica M cameras and Fed cameras are better than Leica M cameras, and in certain really specific situations they may be better, but in all the rest of the situations a Leica M camera is obviously going to be a much more practical and kind of long-term solution. I would buy a Leica camera for life. I wouldn't necessarily buy a Fed or Zorki camera for life. I don't think those cameras are built to last as long as Leica cameras. So with that kind of covered, let's jump straight in. I've been using Leica M film camera since 2014. My first was a Leica M2. Since then I bought a M3, an M4P and an M6. And then more recently I got into Leica 3 cameras and I've got a few different ones. So hopefully I'm in a strong position where I've got experience using quite a few different models and I understand the pros and cons of each model. If you prefer information in written format, just check out MrLeica.com blog. I'll put some links in below. So firstly, Leica M cameras. You may have already seen the video I've done of the Leica M4P versus the Leica M6. I'm not going to cover every single detail of every single camera in this video to try and keep it shorter. So watch the videos I've already done if that's the camera model you're interested in. Equally, I've also done a video of the Leica M3 versus a Leica M2. Excuse all the different setups, I just grabbed a handful of cameras. I should probably make the excuse at this point in the video and say there are quite a lot of Leica camera variants. There's a very high probability that I will not cover every single model in this video. I'll just try and cover the most popular models. So in Leica M cameras, you've got Leica M3, Leica M2, Leica M4, Leica M42, Leica MP, Leica M5, Leica M6, a few different variations, Leica M7, and then the film cameras which are still made today, the Leica MP and the Leica MA. So these are all Leica M rangefinder cameras, and all of these cameras have a set of criteria which is the same in every camera. So let's just go through these. Some of the comments are just my opinion and some of the comments are fact. So I'd say Leica M cameras are built to last and they are precision made instruments. Leica M cameras are quiet and quick to use, hence they're very popular for street photography. Leica M cameras have a maximum shutter speed of 1 over 1000 and a maximum flash sync speed of 1 over 50. This is across the range. I'll just state the obvious. All Leica M cameras are Leica M mount or Leica M bayonet fit cameras, and all of these cameras are 35mm rangefinder cameras. This camera's got no filming, so I can show you. All Leica M film cameras are bottom loading or back loading, depending on how you describe it. So you take the bottom plate off on all models and you open the back door like so. You load your film as shown here, and this is the same on all models. And the film is loaded via the base plate. There are some slight differences on fast loading and slow loading, but you'll see those details in my other videos. With the exception of the Leica M3, all of the Leica M cameras focus to a close focus distance of 0.7 meters. And once you start using a lot of other rangefinder cameras, you'll realize that Leica M cameras focus closer than most other rangefinder cameras. This is really useful if, like me, you'd shoot portraits. Leica M3s are 1 meter close focus distance, but you can get them modified to 0.7 meters. So my Leica M3 cameras are modified to 0.7 meters. So that's the common features of Leica M cameras. I'll go back and look at some more specifics in a second. Next we have Leica 3 cameras or Barnack Leicas. All Leica 3 cameras are Leica thread mount or Leica screw mount, often called LTM or L39 thread. All Leica 3 cameras are smaller, lighter and more compact than a Leica M camera. Sizes vary slightly, but across the board, every Leica 3 camera is lighter than every Leica M camera. Here's a quick side-by-side comparison of a Leica M next to a Leica 3 camera. Leica 3 cameras have a close focus distance of 1 meter, so you can't get as close as you can with your M cameras. As with the early Leica M cameras, the Leica M3, the Leica M2, Leica Barnack cameras are extremely well made and really nice precision finish. I think the closest M camera to a Leica 3 camera is the Leica M3, from my experience. All Leica 3 cameras work without a battery and do not offer a light meter. I'm just checking if this camera's got any film in before I open the bottom plate. No, I think we're okay. All Leica 3 cameras are bottom loading only. And the back door does not open. It's also recommended that you cut your film leader longer when loading Leica 3 cameras to reduce the chance of them jamming. I've already done videos on loading Leica 3 cameras and film loading in Leica M cameras, so again you can check those out if you're interested. So that's some of the common features from both types of camera. If we now look at Leica 3 cameras in a bit more detail, there are four different kind of styles as I see it of Leica Barnack camera. Excuse the lens on some of these cameras. The simplest version of the Leica 3 camera is the Leica 1C and the Leica 1F. It has no rangefinder and no viewfinder, the same as the Leica MDA, which is the same concept. So no rangefinder, no viewfinder. This gives you the smallest, lightest setup of any Leica film camera. Option 2, some of the early Leica cameras, I've got a viewfinder on the top plate, but no rangefinder. This makes it more compact than a camera with a built-in rangefinder and built-in viewfinder. These cameras were supplied with a separate rangefinder for those that want to use them, and this fits on the top plate. If you're already subscribed, you'll see this in a future video. So this is a rangefinder setup on this early Leica 1 Model C camera. So that's option 2, built-in viewfinder, no built-in rangefinder. And then the third type, which is probably the most common, you have a built-in viewfinder and a built-in rangefinder. Early models of this type of camera have a separate viewfinder window and rangefinder window on the back of the camera. And then later models had one eyepiece with a rangefinder and viewfinder built in. So these are the most common Leica 3 cameras, Leica 3A, Leica 3C, Leica 2F, Leica 3F, most of the popular ones. Built-in viewfinder, built-in rangefinder, but two separate windows. I'll cover this again at the end, but one obvious difference between a Leica 3 camera and a Leica M camera is a Leica 3 camera has the two separate windows, so it's a two-step process. You use the rangefinder to focus your image, then you use your viewfinder to compose your image, then you take your picture. Or like M cameras have a combined viewfinder and rangefinder in a single window. This makes M cameras faster to use in some situations. And lastly, talking about Barnack cameras, the fourth type of Barnack camera is a standard rangefinder window, but a large viewfinder. So this is the Leica 3G. This was the last of the Leica 3 cameras, offering a bigger viewfinder, and this is made around the same time as the Leica M3. One common complaint about Leica 3 cameras is the viewfinder is too small. The Leica 3G has the biggest viewfinder for those of you that like a bigger finder, where you want to stay with a Leica 3 camera. And just while we're on this point, it's probably worth noting you can have a brighter viewfinder on a Barnack because you can fit any manufacturer viewfinder onto your cold tube on the top plate. So you can use a Brightline Voigtlander viewfinder, or you can use Leica viewfinders. These viewfinders can be extremely big and bright, so don't feel you're restricted to the tiny viewfinder built in the camera in these cameras. Okay, so one way to look at these cameras may be to talk about the features or talk about lenses and then tell you, depending on which lens you want to use, I can suggest what camera body I think is best for you. So maybe let's look at it like that. So in no particular order, if you shoot with a 50mm lens, 20mm lens, 21mm lens or 25mm lens, I would recommend using a Leica Barnack camera with a wide angle viewfinder on the top plate. The reason I say this is because Leica 3 cameras are smaller than Leica M cameras, so you don't really need to carry the weight of a Leica M camera, where you're going to have to use the same hot shoe viewfinder regardless of whether it's a Leica 3 camera or a Leica M camera. The other point worth noting is if you're shooting with 50mm, 20mm, 21mm, even 25mm, The depth of field of these lenses is so deep that you don't really need to use a rangefinder to focus. So my go-to setup is using like a three cameras with no rangefinder, because I can just scale focus or zone focus with 50mm, 20mm, 21mm. This gives you a really compact setup, as I've already covered in one of my other videos. The caveat to that is if you want to use a like an M-mount wide-angle lens, then of course you're going to have to use a like an M-mount camera. You can't mount like an M-mount lenses onto like a three cameras, but you can mount screw mount lenses onto M cameras. So the good news is if you buy like a screw mount lenses, you can use them on both bodies. But if you use like an M-mount lenses, you're restricted to only M bodies. If you enjoy using small, slow 50mm lenses such as this 5cm Elmar f3.5, I would recommend using a Barnack camera, not a like M camera, because if you're going to have a small lens, you may as well have a small body to go with a small lens. And these cameras are built with a 50mm viewfinder, so it makes sense to have a 50mm lens on a camera designed for a 50mm lens, giving you the smallest possible package. So small 50mm lenses, I would recommend Barnack cameras and not like M cameras. Now, if however you like using fast 50mm lenses, I would highly recommend using a like M3 camera over any other camera. The Leica M3 camera has a single 50mm frame line, giving you a really nice clear view, and has the most magnified viewfinder, 0.91 magnification, giving you the best chance of hitting focus with your fast 50mm lens. So Leica M3 is my choice if you're using a fast 50mm lens. The only caveat to that statement is if you are a glasses wearer, it can be difficult to see the 50mm frame lines if you wear glasses and use an M3. So in that case, it may be better to use a Leica M2. The Leica M2 is my personal choice if I shoot with a 35mm lens, because again, it's the only Leica M camera to have a single 35mm frame line, and it just gives you a really nice clear view, and it's a really precision made camera. So that is my go-to camera for 35mm. I probably should have also mentioned with the Leica M3, if you shoot with a 90mm or a 135mm, the Leica M3, in my mind, is the best bet. You have individual frame lines for those focal lengths, and also because it's the most magnified viewfinder, you've got the best chance of critically focusing those longer lenses. Okay, but what if you're a 28mm shooter? If you're a 28mm shooter, I'd recommend getting the Leica M4P or the Leica M6. The Leica M4P and the Leica M6 have 28mm frame lines, giving you a clear view of your wider composition. It's probably worth mentioning you could use a Leica M3 and use the entire viewfinder for 28mm. And on that note, if you shoot 40mm, such as a 40mm Voigtlander lens, I sometimes use my Leica M3 and use the entire viewfinder for 40mm composition. So 40mm, Leica M3, 28mm. If you want frame lines, use a M4P or an M6. If you're not bothered about frame lines, you could use an M2. If you want to shoot 75mm lenses, such as those made by Leica and Voigtlander, again, I would recommend either the Leica M4P or the Leica M6. Both of those cameras have the 75mm frame lines, and being older cameras, they tend to be cheaper than the later models. Talking about those of you that wear spectacles, if you want to shoot 28mm but you wear glasses, there's a Leica M6 and a Leica M7 made with a 0.58 magnification viewfinder, which gives you more space around the 28mm frame line, meaning you can see your 28mm frame line edges. The downside for the low magnification viewfinders is it is then more difficult to critically focus fast lenses or long lenses. Okay, but what if you're only interested in cameras with a light meter? As already mentioned, if you want a light meter, that means you cannot use any Leica 3 camera, because none of those offer light meters. And then for Leica M cameras, you're limited to Leica M5, Leica M6, Leica M7, Leica MP. And I know this is less popular for Leica shooters, but what if you want to use flash? If you want a camera with a hot shoe, meaning this is live, so you can fire speed lights or triggers from the top of your camera, rather than a cold shoe where you have to use the ports on the back to power the unit on the cold shoe, then you can buy any camera except the Leica M2, Leica M3, Leica M4. So every camera except the M2, M3, M4, the earlier models, have hot shoes, and those older models have cold shoes. The reason I bought my M4P originally because I wanted to use flash and I need a hot shoe. Now, I could probably talk for 30 minutes about every different camera, but as I say, I've done quite a lot of videos for these cameras already, so I'm trying to keep this really summarised. So, in summary, Leica M cameras are faster to use because they have a combined viewfinder and rangefinder. They are faster to load and you don't need to cut the film leader. They are better for me for portraits because I can focus at 0.7 meters close focus distance rather than being limited to 1 meter with Leica 3 cameras. Leica M cameras were built after Leica 3 cameras, so they generally have less problems and often need less money spending on them in terms of CLA and servicing. Most of my Leica 3 cameras have had to go for full CLAs because of the age of the cameras. These cameras are 80, 90 years old, so you're going to expect that they're going to need to have a service. If you like mod cons such as TTL and light meter, things like that, you're better with Leica M cameras. And remember, if you want to use the latest lenses, whether it's the 50mm APO, 35mm APO, or any of the other spherical lenses, you can only use Leica M mount lenses on Leica M mount cameras. So there's no point in you buying a really nice Leica 3 camera if all your lenses are M mount. And I'm just stating the obvious, but it's probably worth thinking about lens first, camera second. So that's Leica M cameras. And what about Leica 3 cameras? To summarize, Leica 3 cameras are slower to use. They are small, light, ideal for travel. You are limited to using Leica thread mount lenses, and they're probably 2/3 the cost of a cheapest Leica M camera. So Leica 3 cameras do offer you a cheap entrance into the world of Leica film cameras. As at April 2021, as most of you watching will know, there are extremely few new film cameras being made today. The great news is Leica still make the Leica MP and the Leica MA. Now I did some research and there are Leica MPs in stock. The shop that I looked at, the Leica MAs were coming in around the middle of this month. Now it seems from what I see on social media that the most desirable camera is the Leica MP. But feel free to let me know in the comments what you think is the best Leica camera. If you want a brand new Leica MP or a brand new Leica MA, they cost around £4,100, brand new, and that is around $5,400. The main difference between the MP and the MA, the MP is more similar to an M6 and offers you a light meter, where the MA is more similar to, say, an M3 and it doesn't have a light meter, in very simple terms. If you're still totally confused on what Leica to buy, always feel free to reach out to me on Patreon and I can talk you through the different models and what might be right for your personal situation. There's not one Leica camera which is the best camera for everybody. Depending on everyone's individual interests and needs, there is a camera which will probably suit you better than the others. If you want to know what I use the most, I use a Leica M3 for portraits because it's faster to use than a Barnett camera and it allows me to quickly and precisely focus portraits at 0.7 meters when desired. And then for everything except portraits, I tend to use Barnett cameras because I much prefer the smaller size and lighter weight. And as I say, check the blog if you want to see details of all of these cameras in written format. If you want to see in-depth reviews on some of these cameras, I've already done the Leica M3 versus Leica M2 video. I've done the Leica M6 versus Leica M4P video. I've done the Leica 3A versus Leica 3G. I've done a Leica 3 versus Leica M3 video. And then my camera of the year for 2020 was a Leica 2F. And I've also covered the Leica 1C and the Leica 1F. If you like your Leica cameras, feel free to subscribe. And as I say, there will be a video coming on my new black Leica Barnett camera. And also, if you enjoy Leica chat, I do a lot of Leica content over on Patreon as well. So feel free to check that out. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button. And with that said, a big thank you as always to my patrons and see you again in the next video. Bye.